what I want to teach you today is how to take a really good photograph of your painting using just your cell phone. Cell phones today have pretty good cameras and real high resolution. The biggest issue with cell phones is that, number one, they tend to overexpose everything, and very few people know how to set up the camera to shoot in manual. Some cell phone cameras cannot be set to manual. And the other issue is that you get distortion on the outside of the, as you approach the edge of the frame, you get some distortion, so that if you're taking, for instance, pictures of some buildings, the lines start to curve, or if somebody's head's on the edge, they get kind of stretched out. So I'm going to show you how to remedy those two problems, using a cell phone. And so the simplest thing to do is we're going to start by taking your painting out in full bright sun. And a lot of times people think that bright sun is going to create glare, but it's not the brightness of the sun that creates the glare, it's the direction of the light. So as you can see, what I've done here is my wife Emily is holding the painting, and she is just standing inside of the sun, where the sun is hitting the painting. But as you can see, right in front of her feet is the shadow of the tree. And now if I step back here and move the camera around, you can see that basically there's a big shade tree. In fact, there's several shade trees. So that directly behind me, and I'm sitting there holding the cell phone, behind me, the person holding the cell phone, it should be dark, because that's where the glare is going to come from. It's going to come directly from behind the person holding the cell phone taking the picture. So you don't want that area to be bright. And as you can see, I've got all the shade trees in there, and there's a little bit of grass showing through, which is not a big deal. But the majority of the light, 98% of it is coming directly from the sun. It's hitting the painting at an angle. And here's a diagram that shows you kind of how everything's lined up. You can hit pause and make some notes from this picture, even take a picture of your screen with this diagram set up, so you can see exactly where to stand and where the person holding the camera should stand. But you can see here I am, and I'm very close to the painting because that's the way cell phones are. That's that fisheye effect, so I have to get in close to get anywhere near filling up the frame. But I don't want to fill up the frame completely. I want to move in close and hold the cell phone in such a way that I frame it about like this picture here. As you can see, I've got plenty of border around the outside of the painting, and that's so that we minimize the distortion that's created by this, fisheye lens that cell phones have. And then the other thing I've done is you'll notice that Emily's wearing a white shirt. And the reason she's wearing a white shirt is by including her in the frame, your cell phone is going to naturally darken it down, because it's going to try to compensate for that bright white t-shirt. And that'll probably bring your painting close to the exposure that you need. But if you still don't get it dark enough, just by including a white shirt in the frame like you see here, if it still needs to go darker, most cell phones, I think the vast majority, whether you're using an iPhone or an Android phone, you can tap right on the screen and tap on various parts of the picture, and it will adjust the exposure accordingly. So that if I tap on a bright white shirt, it's going to darken it down to try to compensate for that bright white shirt. And in so doing, it will darken your painting as well. So by tapping around on your phone on the picture, And if you're, I think that in some phones you're going to have to go in and set your camera to do this. But by default, I think they all work this way now. And that is that if you tap on different parts of the scene, you'll get different exposures. So when you take your picture of your painting, go ahead and tap all over the place and get as many different exposures. Some too dark, some too light, some as what you think is perfect. And that way you'll have a lot of different exposures. And then once you get your photo on your cell phone, you're going to want to edit it, and just go in and you can do all the editing right on your phone, and you're going to want to crop it down so that you only have your painting in the frame. And then you save it like that, and there's your good picture of your painting. Now, one thing to note, and this is you're going to have to take some time when you take your picture to make sure you're doing this, and that is the person holding the painting needs to hold the painting perfectly vertical, meaning perpendicular to the ground, not leaning back. If it's leaning back, you're going to get a little bit of glare on the top of your painting, like you see in this picture here. So have them hold it straight vertical, and then when you hold the person holding the cell phone, they need to really take their time. Move it up, move it down, move it left, move it right, so that it's not only centered in the frame, but also that it's perpendicular, so that if here's your painting, you want your cell phone to be perfectly, you don't want it looking down, you don't want it looking up, you want it to be perfectly perpendicular. And that's going to minimize the skewing of your painting, because if you're looking down on it, it's going to skew the lines and it won't look square. So that's basically it, how you take good photographs of your painting. But remember, this is really important because, you know, the vast majority of people out there are never going to walk into your home or into your studio and see your actual painting. You're going to either be sharing it online or emailing it to people or putting it on a website. And that's how most people are going to see your painting. And so it's, you know, as much work as you put into your painting, take the time to try to get really good photographs of it. And luckily today's modern cell phone cameras are actually pretty good. And so if you'll do it like I explain here, you'll get great photographs of your paintings.